I've heard tales of your kind, Witcher. You're a mutant. Created by magic. Roaming the continent.
We don't want your kind here.
Hunting monsters. For a price.
Hey, what's going on, guys? It is Jack here, and today I'm actually super excited to show you some custom-printed minifigures from The Witcher. Now, if you don't know what The Witcher is, it started off as a fantasy book series that spanned from the early 1990s to the early 2000s, and it picked up a lot of traction. A lot of people really liked this series, so they made a video game off of it in the mid-2000s, and then two more after that, and we're even waiting on a Witcher 4 right now. In December of 2019, Netflix released their own original series based on the book series and the video games, starring Henry Cavill as the main lead of Geralt. And that's how I actually found The Witcher, but I must say I am in no way as diehard of a fan as people who have read the books and played the video games and watched the Netflix original, but I do like it, like a lot. So today before you, I want to present to you three custom printed minifigs from The Witcher. Before I get into these figures, if you want to buy any minifigures from minifigs.me, whether it be these Witcher figures or anything else in their selection, you can use the code 2020JackHammer10 at checkout to get 10% off your order. Now, these three figures are Geralt, Yennefer, and Geralt again, but it's not the same Geralt. The one on the left is the Henry Cavill version from TV, and the one on the right is the video game version. So I guess it makes sense to start on the left, and we can start with Henry Cavill's version of Geralt. I must say, I like this figure for what he represents and who he represents and just how accurate he is to the character. For some reason, I think minifigs.me nailed the look of his eyes and his face. You can see Henry Cavill in the face, which is weird because when LEGO made Superman, it didn't look like Henry Cavill at all. But I'd say this is pretty accurate, and you can even see the armor and the padding on his chest is also very accurate to the show. I like the studded design. I just think this is a very accurate figure, and even though it's pretty simplistic and it's not as complex as the other Geralt minifigure, I like it so much. I like his chrome silver broadsword, and then you also have custom sprayed hair. Now, because this is custom sprayed and LEGO doesn't make a white or grayish version of this hairpiece, you don't want to mess with this a whole lot, because if you overuse it or overtouch it, you do run the risk of rubbing off some of the paint. But if you use this minifigure like me and just pose him in mocks and keep him on display and don't really play with him, per se, I think you'll be fine. And to be honest, chances are, if you're old enough to watch The Witcher, you're not going to play with your LEGO figs. The next minifigure down the line is Yennefer, and I was actually blown away by Anya's performance in the show. I thought she did an excellent job for a pretty unorthodox version of Yennefer, and you may not understand any of that if you haven't seen the show, but you can appreciate this minifigure for how complex she is. I think minifigs.me did an excellent job of actually printing her dress and her robes. That is pretty accurate, and I like the gold, and I like everything about it. Even the purple eyes, just, they look accurate too. The face doesn't exactly look like Anya, but there's not much they can do to make her look like Yennefer. And her hair isn't custom sprayed. LEGO does make this piece in black. I think this actually was a Wonder Woman hairpiece. I'm not exactly sure, but you can mess with this figure as much as you want because her hair is not sprayed. I would say she's kind of on the same level as the Henry Cavill figure, just because I like how accurate she is and how much she represents and who she represents, and I don't know. I think I'm just nerding out at the show, kind of like I did with Stranger Things. But the final figure here is the gaming version of Geralt, and I don't have much input on this because I can't play the games. In fact, my PC broke a few weeks back, so if it weren't for my PC being broken, I would have played the games before making this video, but in a little bit I'll actually have a new PC, hopefully, and I'll be able to play the games and give more input on this figure. But I do like the way they did this figure because there is a lot of complex parts here and a lot more to this figure than the other two. They stuck a different kind of sword into a LEGO katana holder, which may be unorthodox, and you might think, well, how did they get that in there? By brute force, because you can't pull this sword out, at least not easily, and if you do pull it out, you might have trouble putting it back in. But for people like me who really just display figures and don't exactly do much with them, I think the functionality is not as important as the look of the figure. So if you did want him to have that sword, you could just use the other sword that it comes with. He also comes with a chrome broadsword. Now, just like the other Geralt, he does have custom sprayed hair, so if you don't want to damage this hair, I would not mess with him too much. But as long as you put him on mocks or put him on a shelf and just display him with your other figures, you'll be more than fine. It's not going to come off easily, so I wouldn't worry too much. But that's all I have to say about these figures, and I will go ahead and say that I am going to be making some Witcher mocks, so I would stay tuned for that. Even if you haven't seen The Witcher, they will have some pretty cool techniques, and it will just be pretty much a medieval fantasy build for you. But until that time, you can actually go to minifigs.me and again, use the code 2020JackHammer10 to get 10% off your order. You can pick up these figures, or you can pick up any figure of your choosing. But with that being said, I am signing off, so I will see you guys in the next one. As always, thanks so much for watching, and most importantly, take care.